Hi everyone, this is Jono. You've probably seen all of the buzz and excitement about the Ubuntu Edge Indiegogo campaign, and we've just had a phenomenal response in the first day. Well, we're here at OSCON in Portland, and fortunately I've got one of the devices with me, and I want to give you a quick demo of what it looks and feels like. So, this is the device right here. Now, to be quite clear, this is essentially the case, but it's been precision engineered to look and feel pretty much exactly how it's going to be when it's released. But there's no electronics in this, so I can't turn it on to show you the operating system running. So just to talk about how it feels right now, it feels a good solid piece of hardware. The screen feels like it's just the right kind of size. It doesn't feel flimsy, it doesn't feel like a piece of plastic. You can see it's got this kind of rubberized back on here. We've obviously got the circle of friends that's embossed in the back here. You can see the camera and the flash up here. The buttons on the side of the phone, you can see the volume buttons up here. These feel, again, kind of weighty and significant. They don't feel like they're going to snap off in your pocket because, of course, you know, phones take a lot of abuse when you're walking around with them. You can see here, there's another, I think that's probably the on and off switch. We've got these connectors at the bottom. You've got a standard 3.5-inch jack. This thing here is an MHL connector, which means you can hook it up to a screen. But I'll talk more about that in a second. But just to compare it to the size of some of the devices, this feels like just the right kind of size phone to me. So here we have this is a Nexus 4. So you can see they're about the same kind of, thickness. Obviously this is a little bit smaller. Here we've got a Galaxy Nexus. So just to make it clear, the edge is in the middle. And then to compare it to iPhone 4. So this is an iPhone 4. Obviously the iPhone 4 is a little bit smaller. But it's a pretty good looking device. Really slick, really lots of clean edges. You don't see any screws poking out or anything like that. So let's get these legacy devices out of the way. So let's talk about the specifications. So first of all, this device can boot Ubuntu and Android as well. So this is going to be one of the first devices in the world to dual boot. But what's really unique about this is that when you connect a screen via this connector up here, it will boot a full Ubuntu desktop. So this is where the whole Ubuntu convergence story really fits in. A lot of people have wanted to see this, and a lot of the devices out there right now currently don't support it. But this will. This will be one of the first devices that you can deliver a phone on it, but then you can plug it into a screen and you can get a full Ubuntu desktop. So you can carry around your PC in your pocket. Now to do that, it requires a pretty significant hardware specification. This is going to have the fastest multi-core CPU on the market. It also comes with a significant amount of RAM. It's got 4 gig of RAM and a massive 128 gigabytes of storage as well. So this is fantastic for carrying your video and your music and, you know, your applications and whatever else around with you. So we talked about the screen. The size of the screen is 4.5 inches. And this is a HD screen at 1280 by 720. But it's got this sapphire crystal display, which I hadn't heard of until we started talking about the campaign. But it's basically a super hard material that you can barely scratch. I mean, you'd need a very sharp diamond to scratch it. So when you're walking around all day and you've got this rummaging around in your pocket next to your keys and your wallet and everything else, then this isn't going to get scratched. The other thing, of course, is the camera. So we've got the camera up here. This is a 8 megapixel low light camera, and then we've also got in the front, just this little dot here, a 2 megapixel front camera, so it's going to be fantastic for video conferencing and things like that. In terms of the radios, it's very, very flexible device. It's got dual LTE. You can basically pop your SIM card in here and it's going to work. It's got dual band 802.11n Wi-Fi, so getting connected to networks, and then of course it's got Bluetooth. Bluetooth 4 and near-field communications as well. Other sensors that it's got that are of interest, of course, everybody needs a GPS. It's going to have a GPS in there, accelerometer, it's got a gyro, proximity sensor, a compass, and a barometer as well. In terms of the speakers, I think the speakers are on the bottom over here. These are stereo speakers, and it's got HD audio as well. It's got dual mic recording and active noise cancellation. So, one thing that a lot of work has gone into is the battery. So it's got the silicon anode ion battery, and we're assured that this is going to provide some pretty significantly long battery life, which all of us obviously appreciate. So it's a good looking device. We've been showing it to people at OSCON to rave reviews. And you, friends of the internet, can go and pledge to get yours and go to the Indiegogo campaign page and pick one of these up, and let's change the future. Thank you.